Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear sisters and my brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I received a question today, a very important one in regards to death. This question was sent by a sister in the group, in which she says that when a father of a daughter passes away, i.e. dies, goes to the next life, she dresses all in black, and that is a symbolism of her grief, wears no makeup, and does not smell pleasant, and you know what it is written in our books of fiqh. However, then the question comes in, is it true that she can only be in this state, i.e. of mourning and things like that, only for 3 days for her husband? And she would begin to feel unattracted, because if she stays longer than 3 days, she would begin to be unattracted towards her husband, and that she may be a sinner because she's not fulfilling her husband's needs due to the fact that she looks disorderly, she doesn't look clean, attractive, and so on and so forth. However, when a husband of a woman passes on to the next life, the wife is required to be confined in her own home for 4 months and 10 days. And then she says, yeah, this is so unfair, because the role of a husband pales in comparison to that of the role of what a father sacrificed for his family. And this question is extremely important, and that is because when it comes to death, as Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah alayhi rahmatullah says, the truth of people will come out in two circumstances: at the time of the birth of a child and at the time of death. That is when people are. So when people get married, you will see the true color of people and how much they are close or far from their religion. The same thing when death strikes, and how we look at death. Now, before going into answering the question, I want first that you guys understand one thing. Death is seen from two different sides. How Allah sees it, how we see it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acknowledges in the Quran that death is musiba. Asabatkum musibatul maut. Al musiba is a calamity that befalls on a human. And Allah acknowledges that, and He knows it is a calamity that befalls humans when they lose someone of value to their lives or a human being. Sometimes you hear of someone that died somewhere else in the world and it breaks your heart because of the way they died. Always bear in mind, there is what Allah says in Al-Quran and what the community, the culture, the politics, and men say. Allah has made it clear to the stance of what women should do should their husband die. Allah says in Al-Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُتَوَفَّوْنَ مِنْكُمْ وَيَذَرُونَ أَزْوَاجًا. And as those of you men who die and leave wives behind them. What should these wives do? يَتَرَبَّصْنَ بِأَنفُسِهِنَّ أَرْبَعَةَ أَشْهُرٍ وَعَشْرًا. They should withhold themselves for 4 months and 10 days. And the reason for this is that we make clear and sure that the woman is not pregnant. It's only time that can tell. Well, someone might say, you know, today we have science, we have this. I will tell you, science exists in Europe and maybe in the northern parts of America. But the rest of the world, Africa and the rest of the world, still doesn't have this science. So we go with what the Quran says. It says 4 months, 10 days. That is 100 days that a woman should go through to ensure that she is not pregnant. In these 4 months, 10 days, also, she should not present herself that she is viable for marriage. And the only way for her to do that is not to beautify herself. Beautifying yourself would be wearing nice dresses, would be doing that, because that is how we body language when a man sees a woman. You see, when you walk in the street and you see how women are dressed, how men are dressed, you can pretty much say what kind of people they are. So if you see a woman in the street wearing extremely, extremely mini skirt and showing her chest and things like that, you can pretty much say, but you see another woman wearing a skirt mid-calf or maybe just to the knee and is decently dressed, you can see that. This is why when women go to clubs and they go to that, they dress in a particular way. That's because of the body language, the attraction, all that kind of stuff. And it is not our fault, men or women, that Allah made the body of a woman attractive from head to toe. We men are not attractive, maybe our face, whatever it is, but a woman, her whole entire body has been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as attractive. So put yourself in this thing. When your husband dies, forget, it's not because of the husband. It's not because, as they say in the books of fiqh, to honor the husband. Because I know some women who would pay a lot of money if their husband died tomorrow because of the tyranny and the way he is with her and the misery she's been living on for years, beaten up and all those kind of things. She would pay money maybe to have him died. Obviously, she doesn't want the sin of his death, but they would wish for that person to die. So it's not always about mourning the husband and crying and things like that. It's not nothing to do with that. This is what the men of religion have put. Because when you look at it, they have written a lot in our books of fiqh that a woman for 4 days, 4 months, 10 days, she must show that she is greatly bereaved and she is sad and she is crying her heart out because her husband, the companion of her life, died, and all those nonsense things. But for a man, as Imam Ahmed was asked once, can a man marry if his wife died today? Can he marry tomorrow? He goes, yes, and I would like that for him. Because if a man's wife dies, they say the sunnah is to marry ASAP. But why is a woman? Because that comes from the sick, ill mentality of the Arabs, where they always belittle women as an object of sex. This is a problem that we are facing today, and we have to fight it, and we keep fighting it. Allah didn't say this. His messenger didn't relay this to us. He didn't do it, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. After all, after the death of our mother Khadija, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not marry the next day. It took him years before he married again, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And obviously, when you go to our books, they will justify this because of the migration, because of the wars, because of all these nonsense. That's not true. If a man dies today, your husband dies today, the 4 months, 10 days are purely for two reasons. To ensure you're not pregnant. And your words, you can come, oh, well, I haven't slept with my husband for 3 years, so why should I wait? We say that's your words. We want to see tangible evidences that you are not pregnant. Because there is a huge deal of problems. If you are pregnant and you marry another man and a child is born, we do not know whose child it is. Yesterday we have the DNA, but that is not always an absolute science. So if we have a progeny from this guy here, and then let's say the child grows old and he becomes a young man and he marries another girl, but that girl is haram for him. But because we thought he was the child of this man, and you can see the problems that we have. So this is reason number one. And the reason number two, why she should not be attractive, is that she cuts the headaches from any man approaching her to marry. And that is how they used to do it before. Even now, in the Arab world, on all these things, a woman shows that she is ready for marriage in dressing a particular way, behaving in a certain particular way, that gives us the clues that this girl is ready for marriage. So as you can see, it's got nothing to do with this. I find it also very heavy on my heart that when a man dies, the woman stays. And when you read in the books of fiqh, it's mind-boggling. It creates a brain freeze. They will always tell you she stays 4 months and 10 days in respect to the death of her husband, in loyalty to him. Well, because they think of a woman as a sex object. She is the one that has to observe this. She is the one that has to bear the burden of the death of the man. But if she dies, he marries the next day. Why doesn't he respect the death of his wife? Why doesn't he respect the love of his wife? Why doesn't he? Because a lot of our religion has been designed by man for man. And women are only a screwdriver that we drive a screw into the wall. They are just a piece of utensil that you need to use to get to a certain end, and that certain end is to have babies. And this is absolutely appalling. It's absolutely nonsense. Neither Allah nor His Messenger, in relaying what Allah has bestowed upon him, has ever said that. All this is only speculation of man, and you can debate these issues anytime you want. They will tell you in the books of fiqh, there is an agreement between the four imams, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, and Ahmed. Who cares? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. And if you follow him, you will be guided. He didn't tell us about all these great imams. And also, always remember, that for about 10 centuries of our Muslim life, Muslims have never agreed together. They have always been in battles in the school of thought. And at one point, and I strongly refer you to go to my YouTube channel and listen to my talk about 14 centuries in less than 1 hour. And you will hear there how the school of thought have created a havoc in our lives when they differentiated about everything. And at one point until today, they still consider Imam Abu Hanifa, and this is in Saudi Arabia, and the Salafi Wahhabis, they're thinking that he is a disbeliever. And there are YouTube clips in Arabic, talks upon talks, about why Abu Hanifa is a kafir. And this is unbelievable. And at one point in life, they say a woman from the Shafi'i school of thought cannot marry a man from the Hanafi. Subhanallah, we can marry a Jew and a Christian, and we cannot marry another Muslim that prays. This is the headaches created by the school of thought, and that is what man-made religion has made. Allah didn't mention anything about honoring the husband and all that nonsense. He is just a human being that died. Now, because you don't get married to your father, we do not need the 4 months, 10 days. I repeat, because you don't get married to your mother or to your brother or to your father, we don't need the 4 months and 10 days. We don't need a woman to stay 4 months and 10 days. If the husband didn't produce children with these women, 3 days are far more than enough. And that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in the authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, when he said that the hidad, and that is the moaning and the brief and bereaving and all these things that we observe, is for 3 days, both for men and women. If my wife died tomorrow, then it's 3 days that I should be, that is the shock, that is the feeling sad that I've lost a significant part of me. But guess what? Life goes on, because we Muslims know that death is not the end of the path. The same thing, if a woman loses her brother because she doesn't make babies for the brothers, then there is no need for her to go for the 4 months, 10 days, 3 days, and we move on. Because some people, after the death of their people, they stay for years dwelling on the death. It's gone. You can't change. You can't possibly. It's not about paying 100 gazillion or trizillion money to bring them back. They're gone. So get over it. Trust the matter to Allah and move on. I will go back again. The husband, I have personally lost my daughter to this thinking that the husband is far more important than the father. I can't believe it, how my daughter has been brainwashed and she behaves in some... I am a victim of that, and I can relate to that from the bottom of my heart. No, no, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the whole Quran has many times ordered mankind, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah has specifically given every human being on earth a command, and that command is that they be extremely caring, loving, respectful, and show the very best of them to the parents. None of it is to the husband. But this mentality, the sick mentality of some hadith that we don't even know if they come from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam or not, put the husband before the father. So much so that you tell people, Allah in Al-Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكُمْ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ. Allah has commanded in Al-Quran so that you do not worship any other but Allah. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And to the same level of the command, not to associate with Allah, to be great to the parents. It is a disease, a sickness, a really narrow, black, stupid belief that the husband comes before the parents. Unbelievable. On the day of Al-Qiyamah, every human being would put forth his children, his brothers, his wealth, the entire humanity, his entire family, he would give them as a ransom so that he doesn't go into hell. Except the parents, he will not be able to do that. There is not an ayah in the whole Quran where a person would say that I will give my parents as a ransom. And do you know why? Because on that day you want the mercy of Allah. On that day you wish Allah will pardon your sins. And you cannot ransom your parents that Allah has specifically in His book mentioned that you should honor them. You should always put your parents higher than what you put everyone else. You can't go to Allah and say, I give my mother and my father in my place, because Allah will turn to you and say, haven't I said to you that you should hold your parents in a special position? So as you can see here, there is not an ayah in Al-Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the husband or the wife high above the parents. It is the sick mentality of the man, male, macho designed religion that has created that misunderstanding in you and that unfairness. That unfairness does not, and I understand when you say you feel unfair, it is not unfair when you are, because you make babies with your husband, we have to go 4 months and 10 days to make sure that you don't carry any babies. And this is, always remember, Al-Quran is not for Saudis. And today, anyway, we know a lot about that kind of thinking. But Al-Quran is for humanity, entire humanity. People in China, North America, South America, Australia, every four corners of the world, Al-Quran is for them. Not every humans out there have technology. And as such, they must wait 100 days before a woman can remarry. Before that, she can't, because Allah doesn't want the progeny to mix. It's got nothing to do with the husband. Anything else added because of the husband, because of this, is a man, macho, made, designed religion. If there is on earth someone who is unstable as a male, it's the Arab Muslim world. Believe me, Muslim world, they don't have the independence. They don't have the self-confidence. They have nothing. All they rely upon, you must obey me because Allah says that. Where in Al-Quran, Allah says that a woman must obey a husband? Doesn't Allah says in Al-Quran that both men and women should obey Allah? Should they submit to Allah? All this is created to manipulate women. And this disease will change. Saudi Arabia, the Salafi, the Wahhabi, all that kind of extremism preaching is fallen now. It has fallen, and we can see now through the faces of the Saudis now. Pretty soon, next year, you'll see women, probably in the next 10 years, you'll see women with skirt and miniskirt in Saudi Arabia. And the Salafi thinking and the Wahhabi thinking will be classified as terrorists. Mark my words, pretty soon the war is going to be on those extremist Salafis who are going to find themselves cornered, because the world can dispense with that understanding. The website of Islam QA will disappear because of a lot of extremist thinking of the like this ones here. A lot of the macho man-designed religion will go to the trash, because that's where it belongs. Because the book of Allah was put forth behind our back, and now we listen to what Abu Hanifa says, and the Shafi'i, and the school of thought, or this government scholar, or that sheikh, or that website, or this. Because the book of Allah says, يَتَرَبَّصْنَ بِأَنفُسِهِنْ, that means they should wait upon themselves for 4 months, 10 days, so that we know what's in their stomachs. After that, a woman can do, she can marry who she likes. But because of the iron fist of the macho man religion that we have been shown these days, decides for women what they should do, when Allah has given women as much as freedom as He gave to the man, within the boundaries of Islam, within the boundaries of what Allah wants, not what the community wants. Despite of what's being taught today, you can't put a price on parents. If your parents die, you will not get any other parents. If your husband dies, you can marry tomorrow. Always remember this. And Allah knows more. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. This is your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. To join my group, just send me a message on WhatsApp on 078-76-40-8735. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.